You only get one shot at this. How do you want to live it?
Health. Did you know that 1 in 4 children in Australia are overweight? And when we look at adults, 2 out of every 3 adults are overweight. Over a few months ago, I detailed that I go to the gym, I take pride in keeping my health up, and a lot of you guys wanted to take a look into how the Yes Man keeps up his daily regimen of working so many hours every day, but also still managing to go to the gym, still managing to eat okay, and still managing to keep everything in check. So this is going to be a 3-part series on how you can be a healthy geek. In 2005, 20% of Australian adults were obese. They predicted back then that this number would balloon out to 29%. And sure enough, here we are in 2018. With nearly 30% of Australians being obese. So today, ladies and gentlemen, even though it's 1 a.m. in the morning, I'm gonna go to the gym because I've been working all day, been cutting videos, but I still have to keep up my energy, still have to keep up my health. So this is part one, the workout regime. Let's go down to the gym and I'll show you what exercises I do and how you can implement even the basic ones if you're time strapped, time poor, to make sure you're getting that good exercise in your life. So it's now 11 a.m. in the morning, and what happened was last night I went to the gym really late. I couldn't record there, unfortunately, because they're blasting music really loud to the point where there'd be no voice work coming out. And so I got home, I cut a video, and then I went to bed at 5 a.m. I woke up, it's now 11 a.m., and this is the life of a YouTuber. But the one point I'm gonna make is that I only got 6 hours sleep, yet I feel really good. And this is because when you do cardiovascular exercise, it helps you sleep more efficiently. If you're gonna go to the gym or you're only gonna do one exercise, and if you've only got time for that, then ladies and gentlemen, do me a favor, please do cardiovascular exercise. They recommend 3 times a week, 20 minutes. I'd recommend, if you can, every single day. Me personally, I always do 15 to 20 minutes cardiovascular after every exercise. And I know there's some professional bodybuilders out there that are gonna disagree with me maybe, but this is not a video for professional bodybuilders. This is just a video on how I do things personally, how I keep up my exercise, how I keep up my energy, and more importantly, how I keep up my game. So cardiovascular aside, what else can we do in our weekly schedule? Well, if you're sitting in front of a computer, there's also 3 more important exercises, in my opinion, that you should be doing at the very minimum. The first of it is chin-ups. So chin-ups will end up working out your shoulders, your spine, also your elbows and your forearms. And then we can quickly turn that around and also combine some pull-ups into this mix. This will work out the biceps, let you crank up a little bit, and also make you look good on top of feeling good. Now I generally do 2 sets of each, the first set being 20, then the subsequent 3 sets being 3 each, and then I alternate them between workouts. Now the next exercise is very important if you don't have a whole lot of time, but you're in front of a computer all day, that is wrists. Because you're in front of a computer, you're more susceptible to getting a thing called RSI, which is repetitive strain injury. And this essentially can cause you a lot of pain, a lot of ache. What you should be doing at the gym is I personally get a 10 kilogram weight, which I can hold with both hands. And then I end up exercising my wrists. I do this about 35 times one way, and then I change to the other direction and do it about 25 times. And then I do 3 sets of the first set and then 2 sets of the subsequent set. But after this, you should also feel a burn in your forearms because it doesn't just work out your wrists, it works out your forearms as well. Another bonus I throw on top of the wrists is I grab two 2-kilogram weights and then I twirl them to left and right. Kind of like you're at a rave party and you're trying to show everyone your LED lights. This will actually, if you haven't done it in a long time or if you use a computer too much, this should really hurt at first. For me personally now, it doesn't hurt one bit. When I'm on a computer as well, I can type really fast. My wrists give me no problems whatsoever. I do two sets of these for 25 seconds a go. So now you've got cardio, chin-ups, pull-ups, and also your wrists under control. What else do you need to do, ladies and gentlemen? Well, I do recommend the last crucial exercise, and that is simply sit-ups. If you just get a nice little soft mat, if you're like me and you go to the gym in jeans sometimes, you can then just quickly take your belt off because that'll start digging into your back. And then you can just do sit-ups. I like to do 34 at a time. And then I mix in two sets of shin raises. So one set of sit-ups, one set of shin raises, one set of sit-ups, one set of shin raises, and then the final set of sit-ups. So that is all there is to it, ladies and gentlemen, with the crucial workout. If you are doing this every week, at least 3 times a week in your workout, then you should feel a lot better. You should be sleeping more efficiently, you should have more energy during the day, but not only that, you should be thinking more clearly, and this is going to tie in with the other two parts of this series as well. Now, before going on with some of the extra exercises I'm going to throw in this video, I will say one thing. If time is a limiting factor, and I'm sure it's going to be a limiting factor for a lot of people out there, try and think of it this way. If you're going to exercise, at least doing cardio 3 times a week for 20 minutes, that's only an hour out of your week at the bare minimum. And that's going to help you sleep more efficiently. So then you're therefore going to save time because you're getting a deep 6 hours sleep as opposed to a sloppy 8. And that's the time already saved every single day because you're going to be sleeping more efficiently. So you have to get to the gym, have to keep up your energy, and it's going to make you feel better in the long run. Anyhow, if you find yourself going to the gym and you find you've got a little bit of extra time on your hands, here's the next set of exercises you can do. My gym I go to is 24 hours a day, and they've got so many different machines for working out, so many different exercises. So of course, a lot of people out there wanna make their upper torso look pretty good, they wanna pump the biceps a little bit, wanna pump the chest a little bit. So the first machine I like to go to now, usually when I do an upper chest workout, is the lateral machine that works out your lats. I do 3 sets with 16 reps each at 50 kilos. After this, I like to then move on to the horizontal bench press where I do 34 reps at 45 kilos each. Don't ask me why I do these reps and I also do these amount of sets. This is just what I feel good with. And also more importantly, when it comes to the gym, guys, don't push yourselves too hard, especially if you're just getting into it. Definitely take your time and ease into a workout that you're comfortable with. And honestly, don't listen to other people when it comes to working out. I'm just giving you the guide on how I do things personally, but let's move on now to the next machine that I use, and that is resistance. So now with this resistance machine, I do a thing called reverse curls. I also do them at 2 sets at 24 reps each. On the first set, I'll have my wrists facing downwards. On the second set, I'll have my wrists facing upwards. So it's a different workout for your triceps in both cases. So in total here, we're doing 4 sets, but 2 sets of each way. And we're doing this at 45 kilo, though I don't think this is actually 45 kilo. I think it's 45 pounds. I think maybe my gym has just mislabeled the weights in this case. Then the next exercise I like to throw in here is for shoulders, because if you don't have strong shoulders, then there's not a lot you'll be doing in terms of other exercises. And so what we do here is a pull down extension. This is really good. It'll work out your shoulders, but also your forearms and also your biceps and triceps, pretty much your whole arms in the process. I do 2 sets of these as well at 16 reps each at 45 kilos after the initial 4 sets on my triceps. And then if I've still got energy, I'll head over to the shoulder press machine and conduct 2 sets with 24 reps each at 36 kilo. Then the last exercise we're gonna go to is, I guess, the holy grail when people think of the gym, and that is your biceps. Here there are so many different exercises you can do, or at least so many different machines and tools you can use to work out your biceps. Here I like to use a variety of equipment, so every few days I'll change up what equipment I'm using to work out my biceps. But at the gym today, we're gonna be using the W-shaped barbell. This is really good, gives your biceps a nice crunch, nice workout. We're using 22.5 kilograms on this bell itself, plus you've got the bar. And so I'll be doing 24 reps, three sets. And you really want to make sure when you're doing these exercises, don't push too much weight. Sure, you can do a few reps at much higher weights, but you risk ripping tendons. And you do not want to do this because it's going to put you out of action for a while. It can also cause you damage in the long run. So I do stress this, only lift weights that you're comfortable with and you've got control over. If you don't have control, especially when you lift things up and you're really struggling to let it go down, that means the weight's too heavy for you. So just drop it down. Don't worry if there's guys at the gym that are massive, don't worry about those guys. You're only gonna be worried about you and how you feel and how you should work out. And so the last exercise I'm doing here to throw into my biceps is just the bicep curl machine. And I just do 24 reps at 36 kilos. And I do three sets on each arm. You can also make it a little bit lighter as you go along because you really wanna feel a burn in your biceps. That means you're working out things really well. And at the end of this workout, you should feel really good. You should still have energy, hopefully. But if you're just getting into the gym, you may feel tired halfway through. You may feel tired at any different time. So just ease your way into a workout. Don't go full on. I've been going to the gym for 3 years now, and I don't think I'm gonna be stopping because it just really makes me feel good. It really helps me with my energy levels, and it really helps me stay focused. And the biggest take out of today's video is, please guys, definitely integrate some exercise into your everyday life. Even just the simple four exercises that I showed at the start will help you a lot. Now, of course, if you wanna gain some muscle and look really good, then me personally, I do recommend if you're throwing in cardio and you're time strapped, always throw it in at the end of the workout. I don't do cardio before I start my workout. I just do 15 to 20 minutes after every workout. And I feel great, I still get the benefits of cardio, but at the same time, I'm not losing too much mass. Anyway, in terms of my stature and weight, I'm currently weighing in at 74 kilograms. I'm 5'10". And that's about it for today's health video, guys, with the exercise. And in terms of pre-workout supplements and other supplements I take, I don't take anything specifically for the gym. If I do feel like I'm a little bit hungry and I wanna eat after I go to the gym, because I do agree with a lot of people that say you should be eating a nice protein-packed meal after you go to the gym, then before the gym, I'll actually eat potato chips. Just, you know, home brand potato chips from the supermarket. They give me a nice burst of energy and I really find they help my workout. Every person you go to will have different recommendations on supplements like creatine and take protein and all this stuff before workouts. Me personally, I just do it all natural and I just eat some potato chips if I need a pick me up before my workout. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed the Tech Health City part one video. Make sure you stay tuned for part two and three, because things are gonna definitely be getting a lot more interesting. But in ways I know they all just tie together to make sure that you're living the best quality life that you can. But anyway, if you enjoyed this video, then be sure to hit that like button. Let me know if you have any questions or comments and drop them in the comments section below. And I'll catch you in another tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.